Welcome to Stories, Shlokas, Sanskar. Thank you to all our subscribers and viewers. If you have not already subscribed to our channel, please do so by clicking the red subscribe button. Namakkal Anjaneyar Temple is a famous Hanuman temple situated in Namakkal, Tamil Nadu, India. It is not only a geological masterpiece but also a thriving abode of faith and devotion. The idol of Hanuman stands tall at 18 feet and is believed to be growing each day. Sri Anjaneya stands with his hands joined in prayer and is a standing testimony to the power of bhakti. He has a sword tied to his waist and a japamala of shaligrams in one hand. Let us learn the story of origin of Namakkal Anjaneya Temple. The origin of this temple dates back to more than 1,000 years when Sri Hanuman was bathing in river Gandaki in Nepal. He found a shaligrama with an auspicious sign of Lord Vishnu in the river. Delighted, he flew away with the shaligrama to install it at an appropriate place. When he was passing over the present-day Namakkal, he saw Devi Lakshmi in deep penance near a lotus pond. Devi Lakshmi was praying for a darshan of the Narsimha Swarup of Lord Vishnu. Sri Hanuman handed over the shaligrama to Devi Lakshmi when he went for his daily prayers. When he failed to return within the stipulated time, Devi Lakshmi placed the shaligrama down according to the divine plan. The shaligrama grew into a mountain. When Hanumanji returned, he could not move the mountain as much as he tried. Lord Narsimha appeared from the mountain and graced both Devi Lakshmi and Sri Hanuman with his darshan. Lord Narsimha promised to reside there forever, and even today we see a cave temple cut into the side of Namagiri as Narsimha Swami Temple. 130 meters away from his temple, we see Namakkal Anjaneya, where Sri Hanuman stands facing Lord Narsimha. The eyes of Hanumanji are at the exact level of the feet of Lord Narsimha. This divine spectacle can be seen from Garuda Alvar Sanidhi. The Hanuman temple is visited by thousands of devotees who have experienced wish fulfillment with regard to health, career, education, and even marriage. The energy of Hanumanji is palpable here, and we imbibe a unique mental and physical strength after we visit this temple. People offer vadamala, garlands of betel leaves, flowers, tulsi and lemon along with milk, fruits and nuts. Why we put vadamale for Sri Hanuman? When Hanuman was a child, he tried to swallow the sun, thinking of it as a mango. Rahu was racing to eclipse the sun at the same time. Being the son of Vayu or wind god, Hanumanji won the race and reached the sun first. Impressed by his valor, Rahu blessed that anyone who prayed sincerely and offered Udad Dal to Hanumanji would be free from Rahu Dosh. Udad Dal is Rahu's favorite, and since he is depicted as half serpent, the Udad Dal is bent like a snake in shape of Vadas. The offering of betel leaves also has a story associated with Devi Sita offering betel leaves to Hanumanji in Ashok Van as thanksgiving. Why is butter offered to Hanumanji? The entire idol of Hanumanji is decorated with white butter on festivals. It is said that Sri Hanuman carried Sri Rama on his shoulders during the war to match the celestial weapons and vehicles of Ravan. To heal all the injuries that Hanumanji sustained in the war, Sri Rama himself applied butter on Hanumanji's body. This is one of Hanuman's favorite offerings. Four main rituals are conducted every day in the Sri Namakkal Anjaneya Temple. A 15-day long festival during Pangini Uttram in the month of March and April include procession of the Lord around the temple and many more festivities. Sri Hanuman is the epitome of courage, physical strength and devotion. Absolute surrender at his holy feet will help us overcome all obstacles in life. Please share this valuable information with your family and friends, and do subscribe to our channel Stories, Shlokas, Sanskar. Thanks for watching.